The economy has been fully reopened with the nighttime curfew lifted, border set free to work through the night, and of course we remember schools opened not long ago. But all of this is happening amidst rising fuel prices, even though the tankers that were stuck at the Kenyan border were able to make it into the country. This is affecting business, of course, and we wait to see how it can be solved. Uganda is also seeking to make the COVID-19 vaccine mandatory for everybody. Welcome to the Business Show. Now we take a look at what's making headlines in the world of business. Uganda seeks to make the COVID-19 vaccination mandatory. Sri Lanka's central bank faces worst financial crisis in decades. And Toyota profits fall by 21% in 3 months after chip shortage.
You never break even if you don't master your inputs and outputs in terms of costs.
You need to look at keenly the packaging.
Welcome to the show. Now, with the very high record of business growth in sub-Saharan Africa for Uganda, it means that so much has been able to take place in the business world, and now we include innovation. However, the question remains the fate of these innovations after they have sprung to life. On Views from the Top tonight, we speak to Yvonne Panga from Business Trends Galore, and she is telling us why some of these innovations never see the light of day after their 1 year of birth, and also what can be done to be able to have these innovations come to life and solve Uganda's problems.
Consultancy. I also double as the chairperson in charge of Business Trendsetters Forum. Most precisely, I'm the executive chairperson for the Business Trendsetters Forum. But besides that, I'm also on the board of the Public Relations Association of Uganda and on the board for publicity for Uganda Women Entrepreneurs, among other things. The Business Trendsetters Forum is about CEOs, business leaders and entrepreneurs that have set notable business trends. We started as far back as 2017, and we had our first convening physical meet and greet event in January 2020. We had the second one in January 2021, and this year, 2022, we're having the third Business Trendsetters Forum, which we have dubbed as the third Business Trendsetters Forum 2022. Like I said, it's about CEOs, business leaders, and entrepreneurs that have set notable business trends. Interestingly, there are many young people who have come up with business ideas and have not been celebrated. So this year, we have come up with a slightly different approach. The Business Trendsetters Forum, with their organizing committee, are actually sending out questions for people to identify the trendsetter of 2021 or the business trendsetter of 2021, youth, female and overall. That makes it a bit different this year. This year we also have breakaway sessions where we have industry significant changes that we are putting in factor. For example, we have the oil and gas, streams and dream. We have the insurance, administration and finance, that is also under that. We also have entrepreneurship and learning, among other things that we'll discuss. We are proud to have a president who of the Business Trendsetters Forum Committee, who actually is also negotiating with the likes of GIZ, the likes of PSFU, the likes of UNP, United Nations Organizations Agencies, so that we have people who understand them, the Millennium Development Goals, the SDGs, to be able to work in tandem with us, because our vision is to ensure continuity and legacy-minded kind of business. By the way, this is a hybrid event. It's both virtual and physical. We believe that the people who are out there in the open should be able to have access. But because people don't attach value to free things, generally, sometimes they should pay at least a modest fee of $3, some like 50,000, so that they attach value. So it is not foolproof that they'll get all the solutions about innovation and setting trends, but it is guaranteed that they won't leave the same. And by the way, the day is March 9th, 2022, just one day after Women's Day. So we believe that women and youth out there should be able to reinvent themselves. Think of how best they can trigger trends for themselves and their children. Think of how the youth are going to live in this post-recovery era, whereby people are thinking, what next? More than 90% of businesses actually more or less collapsed or are not making profits. What innovations can we do to resuscitate and resustain the economy? Those are the questions that will be answered by panelists. I'm happy to report, by the way, Viola, that the oil and gas breakaway session, which we will have on 9th March, has the likes of the private people like Nabanja, the Sinok MD. We have Proscovia. We have people that are moving and shaking the economy. As you know, we just signed the final investment decision. So we are believing that people can afford to continue dreaming and also seeing those dreams come to reality through their innovations and how they fit into that world structure. Then when it comes to learning, we also believe that the likes of Professor Balunywa, who have churned the education sector, should be able to let people know what it means to lead without necessarily losing track of the whole ability to innovate and sustaining the innovation culture as a leader. We also have people like Barbara Arimi of NSSF, Head of Marketing, who will show the people that, listen, you are young entrepreneurs, if the economy is opened, what is it you have to do to ensure that you can now get your products across, your services across in this post-recovery era? When they record, because Madam Sarah will talk about records management, but Shirunda will talk about the fourth estate, the fourth heritage, beyond the fourth heritage actually. When we are in this kind of era, what must we do to see that the future for our children and for the innovators is secure? And those are some of the questions that you won't find anywhere else. By the way, it's the truth, you won't find them anywhere else except on the Business Trendsetters Forum. We have an international icon. He's called Walid, and he's the CEO for PayScale. He's based in Egypt, but he's international. He was part of the team that innovated the finance system for MasterCard Foundation and all. He's also going to be a focal pace setter, and he will show the world what is the future in the digital space, what is the future in the financial systems that we are using today. I can confidently say that part of the trend was the discovery of COVIDx. We did a survey in October last year, and we asked people, have you recognized anybody who has set notable business trends in preparation for this event? And we were surprised that people actually said one of the greatest trends was the development of COVIDx by that Professor Patrick Ogweng. We have seen more ladies become more IT savvy thanks to the teams like Hi People, who have come up with the Women in Financial Technologies. We have seen artists and dramatists go away from stage and actually have their work online and still be appreciated and even paid for. A typical example is Haji Ashraf Simogere, who, by the way, should be one of our panelists for the Learning and Education Entrepreneurship Sector Breakaway Session. And he clearly says that today, just with the use of social media, he's able to reach out to his target audience, whom he used to meet at theatre. Because at first he had to go to theatre. Today he had to set a trend and say, how do I get China Uganda recognized without necessarily going to the people after the COVID came? The digitization era is for real, and the social media marketing is for real. So today, the Jumias, the Safe Borders, and all those are more, the Ubers, all those people that are now online. I know of a youth group that actually came up with Clean It digitally. So if you want somebody to clean, you just have to go on an app. And then I know of people who are selling agricultural products online. I see people who are able to monitor their entire school systems. So those are the latest trends, of course, the last 2 years. They are more IT-based, and we can't run away from that. They are more digitized, and we can't run away from that. But more importantly, we also have to understand that the face-to-face interactions are reducing, although it is not the best. So how do we get families continue to work together? How do we get engineers that are learning online practically understand that? So those are the trends. We have people learning practical subjects over videos and basically online. The Zoom classes are for real. So these are trends that we can't escape from. But still, for practical, for sciences, and I'm told by one of my superiors that chemistry is the only science. So for you to come up with that fabric, you need some mixed cotton and this, that is chemistry. For you to come up with a drug, you need chemistry. So some of these you cannot possibly learn online, but we realize that they're the trends that we are setting, and we have to see how to merge the practical with the theory in a more realistic manner. Innovation, not just in Uganda, but globally, is the future for any industry. In business, we actually say business development, new product development. You can't run away from developing new products or innovating if you're to continue, because people get bored with existing. So you have to keep reinventing yourself, innovating, setting new trends so that you can be able to remain relevant in society. But perhaps what is most even important for us to note as CEOs, business leaders and entrepreneurs, and the business people at large, is that when you have an economy where people are very innovative but nobody harnesses those innovations, then there is a mismatch between the innovations and the development of the products and all that. And that's where people like us are saying we are going to advocate for government intervention. We are going to turn to the private sector. Private Sector Foundation is, we're already in advanced talks to see, yes, you are educating people. They have the skills, but now they're also becoming more innovative. How do you get that recognized for them to be able to do, actually to transform or to translate the innovation into real value for the entire economy and the system? URA, we are thinking about that as well. I had a talk with Ibra, and we are saying, how do you want to collect taxes? But before you can do that, you need to ensure that people are making money. And if they are not making money from the existing structures, then we have to innovate. So we not just have more taxes, but have more people coming up with different ways of making money, so you can have a broader taxable base. So we are looking at all those platforms and avenues as CEOs, business leaders and entrepreneurs. So the future is in additional innovation. The future is in the public and private sector embracing the need to innovate and change, which we call the culture of innovation for continuity, so we can be more legacy-minded and more serious about the whole idea of innovation without just innovate and leave it there. Innovate, harness, cause impact in society. Breaking even for the most basic entrepreneur, as in the person selling, who has been gotten off the streets, let me start with that one. That person who has left the streets, or that hawker who has to be settled in a market, or the first thing is to cut costs. You never break even if you don't master your inputs and outputs in terms of costs. So every business leader out there, every entrepreneur out there should manage costs. Today we are more aware that we have to be disaster prepared. It's amazing, I was reading recently that 94% of companies globally, and that also includes sub-Saharan Africa, actually do not have disaster recovery programs. So when something bad happens, they start panicking. Then we start looking for people to fund us. So we want to go away from that, try to manage and see that even companies, not just individuals, are able to save something, able to put aside a bag which is purely for the rainy day, for recovery in case of any disaster. So that is the first step. Cut costs, prepare for disaster, in whichever best way you can. Then the other recommendation perhaps, and this is now for the bigger players, is to cross-mentor the younger entrepreneurs. You see young people like you, Viola, you all want to go and work for Vision Group, all want to go and work for MTN, you all want to go and work for Airtel, want to go and work for the bigger entities. The public sector, of course, is also there. But we want, I would, my appeal would be that those that are already at the helm of development and innovation, those that have the means and not necessarily looking for external funding, should be able to find ways of how do they cross-mentor the younger people who have a lot of knowledge and ideas but are not able to be harnessed. And that's why as a Business Trendsetters Forum, we're there. See, how do we get that leader, Gerald, proprietor of say a course and head of procurement at NSSF, mentor a young person who is setting up a logistics company? How do we get that international icon from Solid Rock Life and Business Global come to Uganda and get people trained in the whole of Albertine region to see that they are prepared for oil and gas? How do we get Ministry of Energy recognize that Petroleum Authority cannot work without the, we can't get the 70% local content if the local people are not just trained but also trained to be innovative? Because it's one thing to be trained, but it's quite another to prepare your brain for and harness it for innovation and trend setting. That's really the calling that we have for this year. I believe that the people watching out there, those who have set businesses up, those who are hoping to set businesses up, those who are already at the helm of the business market, those that advocate for business setting up like Ministry of Tourism, Trade and Industry, should look out for ways of encouraging innovators, the young people out there who are coming up with innovative ideas, the women and children out there. By the way, today, innovation is not just an art, it's a real science. So let's look out for those things. And let's not also look at only people who are coming up with the Kayola bus, which has batteries, and yet our petrol stations are not able to charge them. Let's look at things that are around us that can help us grow. What is in the farming industry can we innovate to ensure that the food and the value chain is followed through? What in the transport industry can we do better? What in the whatever industry that we are in? Of course, today is oil and gas, but we have many service industries out there. Let's look beyond what we see and look beyond what can be able to be sustainable 10 years from now. And that we can't do without government support, the private sector who are the leaders in innovation, but most importantly, the schools, institutions of learning, which have got to become more practical now that the post-COVID era has taught us that theory is not the way to go, but we have to work in a more practical manner to be able to survive. Thank you.
Thank you for staying with us on The Business Show. We are taking a short break, but we shall be right back with so much more, including what we promised to bring to you back in a series from last week on how to make the money.